This is from Richard Fitzwell.
What?
What is this? Ooh, those look tasty. Enjoy your gift from John Langhurt. Langhurt. He could have brought it himself, but it's Langhurt.
If John's Langhurt so bad, maybe he should quit dicking around sending me candy and see a doctor. Today I'm getting a bunch of new parts for the bass van, and I have a Bass Wars update. Together we're going to watch Mark's new video titled, He Challenged Me. I'm assuming it's about me. I think he might have bought a van. But first, a word from today's sponsor, Ritual. Ritual is a sustainable and environmentally friendly multivitamin brand. They offer specially formulated multivitamins for men, women, children, teens, olds, and even the impregnated. Essential for Men contains 10 high-quality ingredients like vitamin A, D, omega-3, and zinc, which are difficult to get from an average diet alone. No additives, fillers, or colorants, vegan-friendly, sugar-free, non-GMO, gluten-free, and allergen-free. Designed to fill in the gaps of an imperfect diet. I like taking my Essential for Men Ritual multivitamin because I know that it's specially formulated for my old man body. Each pill is minty fresh, and I know I'm not ruining the environment by enhancing my nutrient intake. Ritual is transparent about where they source their ingredients. They offset the environmental imprint of shipping their products by donating to support renewable energy, reforestation, and other energy initiatives. Best part is I get a new bottle shipped right to my door every month for just $1 a day. Ritual now offers essential protein. Fill in the gaps of your imperfect diet with Essential for Men. Get 10% off your first 3 months by using our link, ritual.com/soundman, and discount code SOUNDMAN. Help support a healthy foundation for your body today! Amplified is produced by Soundman Enterprises, Inc. and NVX. Buy genuine Soundman iPad dash kits at soundman.co and find high quality car audio equipment at nvx.com. We are also sponsored by US Alternators, Down for Sound Shop, and Audio Control. You guys are always sending me dicks when I'm hungry and it makes me eat them. I wish my Ritual vitamins were shaped like this. Mmm! It tastes like a runt. This is a Dorman AC bypass pulley. This is for our serpentine conversion. This will need to go right here. Ooh, shit, baby. We gotta get going on this dumbass serpentine conversion. We gotta convert this to a serpent. If John thinks his lang hurt, he should see how my dick feels.
Ooh. What is this? Ooh, look at the size of that sticker.
Shit.
Oh, yeah. Okay, this is the PCM module and the alternator for the bass fan. He hooked us up with a red billet case this time. Looks so dope. Oh, shit. Shit. See, I fucked up and made him build the wrong alternator the first time, which should be over here. Let me grab it because we're gonna have a US alternator PCM module giveaway. Are you ready for this? Let me get all my shit together. Hang on a second. Here's what he originally built. When I had him build this, he suggested that we convert to serpentine because the V-belt pulley style is not gonna be strong enough for the alternator to spin the alternator. So I said, that's a great idea. Let's do that. I bought all the serpentine shit. I got the alternator bracket and all the pulleys. The alternator bracket takes a different alternator style. So Dan said we're giving away this alternator and this PCM module. He built me this new alternator. What if it doesn't fit the bracket? This should fit right in here. Oh, baby. See, now I gotta hunt down all the hardware for this shit, dude. Shit. Yet. Take a look at that sucker, hmm? So we'll figure out how we're gonna do the giveaway for this. GM alternator with PCM module. This is the Mule's alternator with PCM module. I'll probably give this away too and give away the whole damn mule with it. Who wants the mule? Piece of damn dumb shit, dumb.
And this is the F-150 high output alternator that I ran on the F-150. I love this thing. But I never put the PCM module on it. This setup might fit the T-Bird, so I never got a chance to try this with the PCM module.
Maybe we'll give this away too and with the Ford. Who wants a T-Bird, piece of shit?
I think I'm probably gonna quit soon. I can't handle this pressure of performing a serpentine conversion in front of millions of people when I already have a car that doesn't run. And I'm about to pull this motor apart now? What if it doesn't work? And I taint my reputation. I'll write hundreds of people. I guess it could be worse. What's the only thing worse than working on a Chevy, a Volkswagen, and a Ford all at the same time? Working on Mark's Fiat Jeep. On my way to get roadhead again.
Oh, they're coming.
Oh shit, I cut this guy off. I forgot this vehicle doesn't accelerate.
My bad.
Don't mind me just driving around filming myself with a camera. On the way to get roadhead again. I have good news and bad news. The good news is this 2.25-inch thick wood cage really increased the van's structural rigidity. Damn thing handles like a Pinewood Derby race van.
Shit!
The bad news is, Homo Depot fucked me again. Don't have any birch. Now I gotta drive across town to the other. The other stupid deep hole.
Well, this does fit pretty swell right here. Look at that.
Well, this is just swell.
Oh, look at that. Look at that. Look at. Look at this. Look at that. Oh, look at this. Oh, would you look it. Get over in there, you dumb little bitch. Oh, would you look at that.
My Home Depot didn't have any wood. Usually I just lay it in there flat and drive back to the shop with the doors open. I had to drive across town. So I had to shove the boards in like this, is what I'm trying to say. I had to put the boards like this. Now I gotta drive back like this. Jesus Christ, it's hot. Oh. 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 On my way to get roadhead again. Fido! Oh shit. People are saying you better hurry up, EXO, finish this cage. Bitch, I know! Mine is done too! Damn! One dude said EXO's cage is done, he's gonna beat me in the competition. He hasn't even started his door panels yet. And he had a year head start. He had his van a year before me! I don't wanna hear any bullshit! His expanding foam is gonna dry up and rattle out. He's gonna be a rattle trap. He doesn't even have side windows. You're not even gonna be able to see inside of his subwoofer box. I don't wanna hear it! Alright, I dilly dicked around and got 3 sheets of birch and a piece of 1/4-inch birch. What I wanna try to do with this quarter here is I need to make one piece that fits around the window up that C pillar. All the way to the B pillar. That way I could do a 1-inch window. So I need to cut a couple pieces to box in where the slider slides. Cut a piece for this out of the 1/4-inch. Then it'll be ready for some 1-inch acrylic. And the acrylic doesn't need to be cut perfect because it can overlap. I'll have a seam in the middle because it curves a little bit.
So I'll have a piece here, a piece there, and then another piece that'll be angled for the top. So I'll be able to make templates for the acrylic and cut that, and we can paint a nice clean border on it. We'll have to make the inside of the windows look swell before we can stick the glass on.
I just watched Mark Zuckerberg, the car audio nerd's dumb video. And it's not even about me. It's not about me challenging him to build a bass van. It's about him putting in some dumb cheap Chinese J-smell audio tweeters into the dash of his Italian Fiat Jeep. That's like putting soy sauce on your spaghetti. Who challenged him to do that? I'm over here putting out legitimate challenges. And he's over here fucking around taking a soy sauce on spaghetti challenge. I'm being ignored on purpose.
But since we have all this bullshit, we should probably try to start taking a look at this. Heavy duty fan clutch.
Shit.
Look at the reliability.
Reliability.
Look at this. Okay, this is gonna be a fucking nightmare, dude. This is gonna be this is gonna be great for you to watch. Watch me get mad. Look at, where's Scotty Kilmer? Where's baby Scotty when I need him? Hmm? Look, this goes on here.
Whoa.
Okay, we got hardware for this. We're gonna be missing a bunch of shit.
Zorg!
All right, so that goes there, that goes there. Where's that piece, hmm? What about that other piece, hmm? We're gonna assemble the motor on the bench.
What is this piece?
Look, there's Rafa.
You like it, huh?
Oh, baby. Look at that.
Shit, sucker.
Okay, so we gotta figure out which side the smog pump is on. The smog pump on this side, the smog pump on the other goddamn side. Which is it?
Now, if we're taking a gander down here, we can see that we got something. We got something right there. That goes on the water pump atitis.
We're gonna have to pull this fucking front off and really start fucking around down in here if we're gonna get this done. Where's baby Scotty?
Endless money pit.
He should have titled the video, "How to Install a Mini Sound System."
Don't leave that toilet bowl yet, we still have another half turd to slide. Roll the shitty ads.
Upgrade your vehicle's charging system with a high output alternator from US Alternators. Visit usalternators.com. Down for Sound is an authorized dealer and offers the best prices on the brands they carry with the fastest shipping in the industry. Go to downforsoundshop.com. Audio Control has what you need to make your good stereo system sound better. Take a look at Audio Control's full line of equalizers, line drivers, digital signal processors, and more at audiocontrol.com.
Ritual uses vegan algal oil instead of fish oil, which saves the lives of 273 anchovies per bottle on average. My competitor Mark from the Other Car Stereo YouTube channel's taken spoonfuls of fish oil, gave himself fish breath. He should have.
Taking bootleg Scotty Kilmer with me to the junkyard to help hunt down some Chevy droppings.
Pile of junk.
We're running to Pick Apart in Sun Valley to see if we can grab some nuts and bolts for the alternator bracket and all the odds and ends we need. I'm hoping we can And I need to figure out that tensioner doesn't fit on the alternator bracket. So I may have the wrong tensioner. So if we find an Astrovan, which there should be a sea of them, because Chevys break all the time. I'm hoping we can at least look at the motor, figure out what we need to get the Serpentine converted. This is where I'm gonna move when I finish my van. We're just gonna park it right on up here. There should be a free spot. Look at this dystopian paradise. Let's see, okay, over here. This is where you get your methamphetamines. This next one here, crack cocaine. This guy right here, see him? Fake weed out of the Mustang. There's a cord right here. We're gonna grab a couple parts off of him. Here we are in beautiful Sun Valley, California. This is Pick Apart. You can see all these cars here. This is actually just the parking lot. It looks like a junkyard, but this is the parking lot we're gonna go in. This is a newer one. Look at this beaut. This is the baby. Okay, so this should have the newer alternator bracket on it. That looks like my alternator bracket. Yeah, see, I got the wrong tensioner. So if I can grab that tensioner and these bolts for the alternator, because these bolts have little sleeves. There's little sleeves in here that fix the spacing of the alternator. Well, shit howdy, boy. Let's take a look at this bad boy. Was this a fellow dog grooming van? Oh yeah, this is a dog groomer, baby. Look at this. I wonder what they did in here. Oh, this looks like an electrician's van.
It's a meth lab.
It's a retired meth lab. Yeah. This is the Chevy alternator bracket that puts the alternator on the right side. See, this one, the AC compressor is on the left. So I don't know if it would work, but if we got this bracket and the other bracket that I have, we could have an alternator where the AC compressor goes. I'm not sure if I'll grab that here because that's expensive, but maybe I'll take a picture of it and we could figure it out. I kind of want to just get the Serpentine conversion done and working. Then we'll figure out what to do with the second alternator. I do need this fan though. This is the fan we need. It's raining right now. All because of you guys. Dude, yesterday was hot as hell. So I thought I was gonna be sweating my balls off out here. And instead I'm soaking my nuts. My nuts are soaking in a bunch of goddamn oil and water because of this piece of shit. What we're gonna do is we're gonna remove this. The shroud. Yeah. Was accidentally forward. Oh, look at that, baby. Oh, this one has a plastic fan unit. Shit, brother. So this does look like my bracket that I have, except this one's dirty, covered in grime. Oh, it's raining on my dick.
Oh no,
it's raining on my dick and my balls.
Oh, let me cross over your stupid hand.
We prepared for everything except rain. Oh, look at this, huh? Look at that. That's an alternator bolt. You see these dumb little sleeves that are in the bracket?
See these?
I need those. Just remove this belt. Oh yeah, baby.
Let me see your back so they can see it.
What the fuck? I don't know how I ordered the wrong tensioner. I think I have parts from all year Astrovans.
Did you hear that thunder?
Yeah, it's very thunderous. I hear it.
I get struck by lightning, dude.
I hope I don't get struck. Son of a horse's dick and balls. Oh. Okay, I gotta yank this. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Okay, now see what we're gonna have here, boys and girls.
is a part that we need. Like a twin.
Look, you cut your arm.
Oh.
Now you have tetanus, dude.
Oh no, I'm gonna die.
Hepatitis C. CD's nuts on my alternator. The ones I just bought.
Look at that. That's the bitch. That is the bitch. Okay, we're gonna set this in our tray of shit we're keeping. There's a Latinx gentleman in the trunk of a Chevy Impala. Ow! Looking for a taillight bulb. But there's another... Yeah, there's not one white person here, okay? I'm not trying to be racist, but... I feel like a minority. Dude, look at that 3.5 liter VTEC engine right over there in that Honda Odyssey. Damn, I want it.
I know, I was looking at it.
Look at that! Stopped raining. Look at that guy's got himself four wheels. Shit. That's a good get, brother. That's a good get!
Look at this. Alright, that's the wheel we need.
It's a shopping cart wheel. I just went to Walmart.
Get that out of my way.
Oh, I would like to get the studs that attach this whole bracket into the goddamn hook-a-ma-hoo.
The jig-a-ma-roll. The wig-a-ma-jig. The rig-a-ma.
This is the bitch we need.
This stud goes into the motor and this mounts the bracket onto the... It mounts the thing onto the fucking...
I'd like to see Mark even attempt to change the serpentine belt on his Italian Fiat Jeep. How long does it take to boil up a serpentine noodle?
I forgot to disconnect the battery. Well, they give birth to this. Oh yeah, see this? Look at that. Mm-hmm. Oh yeah. Okay, this is for somebody to buy.
Set this right here for you. Buy this.
I did all the hard work for you. Come down to aisle 3, lot 7. There's the stud right here I need to get out. I couldn't get my socket on there. That's for the left side bracket, or the right side bracket. Was I calling this side the right side the whole time? I was probably calling this the right side the whole time.
This is the driver's side, okay?
So we're getting a Chevy truck fan blade, tensioner, our idler pulley, alternator. These are some fan bolts, miscellaneous fan hardware, and water pump bolts. Oh, I need a couple more water pump bolts. I gotta grab off. Driver side bracket bolts, passenger side bracket bolts, alternator spacers and bolts. This better be cheap. Dude, look at these hands. Busted my knuckle.
Doi!
All right, here's my receipt.
$65.10.
They charged me $12.50 for the fan blade, 6 small bolts at 42 cents a piece. The pulley was $10, tensioner $18. Seems like a fairly clean one. That Chevy truck I was looking at had this style on it. So this is for a different vehicular configuration. This fixes that problem. Look at that, baby. Dang, buddy. These are 2 studs and 1 bolt to bolt this whole thing to the motor. What if the holes aren't there for this to bolt to? Then what? Water pump and fan. I stole some fan bolts so we could get this little sucker going. See this here? See, this came with fan bolts. Hmm? How about that, huh?
Here.
Now what we have here, you shit-eating bitch, take a look at these.
Ooh!
This is a crucial score. See these dumb little things here, hmm? All right, we're gonna pop this into this place here. Blam. And this is gonna go like this. See this? You see how that did that? Take a look at this. Take a look down here, you fucking bitch. Go like this, hmm? Mm-mm. Shit, baby. There we go. Was that so hard? Look at that unit.
Now we're looking at a couple nice units. I don't think EXO or Mark have upgraded their alternators. I don't blame Mark. The engine bays of those Italian Fiat Jeeps are a real bowl of spaghetti. And plus, he couldn't tell if he's looking at a belt tensioner or a risotto.
And we have what we need to put this on the motor, as long as it fits on my motor. What if it doesn't fit? Got a dumbass fan. These bolts are for this side. Bam, bam, bam. Power steering pump, got the new pulley. I just have to make sure I have the right power steering pump to give me the correct sticky outage for the sticky outy, for the correct amount of bolts for the water pump. I didn't grab the crank bolts, so I'll have to figure that one out. I'm trying to get as much as I can together so we don't have any downtime on the van. At least I got some wood before we're tearing the motor apart. Now look at that fine unit, huh? Shoot! I think that's this. I don't know if this is on right. What if it doesn't?
Sometimes when you polish a turd, you need to dig into somebody else's turd for some shit you need. Then you can jam that shit into your turd. Makes for a plumper turd to polish. Might come out shinier.
Purchase industry-leading iPad dash kits from the originator at soundman.co. Your car deserves the best. Update your car with an iPad dash kit from soundman.co. Find high-quality car audio gear at nvx.com. NVX is committed to audio quality and innovation. Their high-end car audio components are rated accurately, and they've been proven to perform since 2011. Try NVX at nvx.com.